If you see this not secure message, that means your website does not have an SSL certificate installed, and all information traveling between your users and your server is unencrypted, available for anyone to fetch. While there are paid options to solve this problem, in this video, I'll show you how to get, configure, and install a free SSL certificate. However, most modern web hosting providers usually offer free SSL certificates right from their web hosting dashboard, so that's where I would check first. But there are special circumstances where you don't have access to these tools. In those cases, we can use the DNS settings and Cloudflare. So head on over to dash.cloudflare.com and click sign up. Then enter your email address and password. Of course, you'll need to verify that you don't speak in ones and zeros and proceed. You should be hit with a setup wizard instantly, where all you need to do is enter your domain name for the website you want the SSL certificate for. In my case, it's emit.bun.xyz, and click on continue. Then Cloudflare will try to sell you a plan, but if you scroll down a bit, there is a free option available and you don't need to buy anything. So that's exactly what we're going to use. On this screen, you should see a hyperlink titled Quick Scan. Click this to avoid manual DNS record adding. And if it doesn't work the automatic way, you'll need to head over to your domain name provider DNS settings and enter every single one of the records right here with the add record button. It is tedious, but usually the automatic scan works. Once you're done with the scan, click continue to activation. You should see two containers with Cloudflare name servers in them. Copy the text and head on over to your domain name provider. In my case, it's Porkbun. So I'll need to access DNS or name server settings right here. Then enter both of the name servers from Cloudflare and hit submit. At this point, it might seem like your website is offline, but don't worry, it takes a bit of time for the information about your new name servers to propagate throughout the web. What's going on is basically we're using Cloudflare as a middleman to encrypt and safeguard our traffic. Instead of people going from their computer to your server directly, they'll stop at Cloudflare where the information will be encrypted, guaranteeing you an SSL certificate and additionally protecting your website from overloading with traffic. After some time, like 10 to 15 minutes, you can refresh this page and there should be a green success message. However, by default, Cloudflare activates flexible encryption mode, which encrypts browser to Cloudflare data, but does not encrypt Cloudflare to server data. And since we want our data to be as secure as possible at every step, we'll need to do some configuration ourselves for the best possible results. So to get started, switch your encryption mode to full with this button right here, configure. Under custom SSL, click select and select the full encryption mode, which should encrypt everything from server to end user. Now, for the full encryption method to work, we need to install a certificate onto our origin server. If you're using WordPress, installing a plugin called Really Simple SSL will do the trick, but if you're using a virtual private server, you can simply run these commands when logged into the server instead. However, a bit of a downside of using this Cloudflare method is that only your main domain will get the SSL certificate. If you create any subdomains, they won't automatically get protected with the full encryption active. You would either need to switch to flexible and sacrifice some security, or you can use another free tool called ZeroSSL. By the way, ZeroSSL also works if you don't have access to your name servers, only your website files. So it is useful in other applications as well. So for those who do have access to their DNS settings and can use Cloudflare, the tutorial is pretty much done. Enjoy your SSL certificate. But for those who don't have access to their DNS or want to use SSL certificates on their subdomains instead of just the main domain, what you need to do is head on over to ZeroSSL.com and create a free account. Once you're inside your control panel, click on New Certificate you'll need to enter your website name for which you want your SSL certificate. In my case, it's sub.info.emitbond.xyz. And choose the 90-day certificate. Leave the CSR certificate on, and obviously choose the free plan and click continue. We'll now need to prove to ZeroSSL that this domain name does in fact belong to us, and we're authorized to make any changes to it. So choose file upload for your authentication, select HTTP, and download the authentication file. We'll need to upload this file onto our server. So in your web hosting control panel, look for a button called File Manager. This will allow you to explore the files on your server. This is how it looks on cPanel, by the way, but depending on your web hosting platform, it might be a little bit different. Once inside your file manager, double-click the public_HTML folder. This is where all of your website files are stored. And make sure you have the Show Hidden Folders options enabled if there is one, so all of the folders with the dot in front of them show up. You need to find a folder called .well-known. If it's not there, no problem, you can simply create a new folder and name it .well-known, then create another folder inside it called PKI-validation, and you'll need to upload the file you got from ZeroSSL into PKI-validation. After completing these steps, you can go back to ZeroSSL and click on Verify Domain, proving your ownership of the website. Now, you'll be able to download a zip file with all of the required SSL certificate information. So download it and save it onto your computer, somewhere where you can easily find it. We'll need to copy-paste all of the information from these three files into our web hosting control panel. So navigate back to cPanel, at least that's what I'm using, and search for SSL/TLS settings. You should see this tab pop up. Once inside SSL-TLS settings, click on Manage SSL Sites and scroll down until you see Install an SSL website. Once you're here, select the domain name or a subdomain you need your SSL to be activated on, and we'll need to do some copy-pasting. Open the files you've downloaded using Notepad and paste in the info from each file into the required boxes. There are three in total: certificate, private key, and CA bundle. Finally, hit that install certificate button and it should work. Now, the downside of this method compared to the Cloudflare one is the fact that these certificates are only active for 90 days. And after 90 days, you will need to generate new certificates and copy-paste the information into these boxes all over again. It's a bit annoying, but I mean, it's not that bad. It's just a couple of minutes every 3 months, and you do get free SSL certificates even if you don't have access to your DNS settings. And that's it. Your SSL certificates should be active. Obviously, always the easiest way to do this is simply use a modern web hosting provider like Hostinger, Dreamhost, SiteGround. Basically, all of them have free SSL installers right within the dashboard. So if you want to grab a plan for yourself, I do leave some discount codes for Hostinger and other providers in the description down below. But if you're not sure which web hosting provider you need, watch this video next, where I showcase the best cheap web hosting providers.